That strikes me as a strange move, but what do I know? Is this the Stafford? Is that what this is? This is the Stafford? Okay. Alright, I guess I'll blunder into his Eric Rosen preparation. Maybe Eric's lurking in the chat and can, you know, give me some pointers. Probably. I'll be greedy, hang on to the pawn. I know nothing about the Stafford. I didn't even know this was the Stafford, so. This is gonna be bad. Yeah, there's probably some, like, sack here, right? Am I falling into the Venus flytrap? Yep, here it comes. Dead already? What has Eric done? Yeah. Well, he gets the pawn back, yeah. I see that. But I'm not getting mated. And I've got more pawns in the center. And he's got doubled c-pawns. There is no defense. Yeah, if he says GG right now, then I might have to end the stream. White is fine here. Fool Dan telling me the truth. I hope. Queen e2, queen f3. Let's try queen f3. White is winning! F3 is the gangster move? Yeah, we got a sack on F7. Yeah, he's got stuff all up in my grill, too. Pretty annoying. Now, if you want to see a gangster move, King E2 is a gangster move. But I'm not that brave or stupid one. But that would be the most gangster move in the position. I mean, I'm not castle. I can't castle anyway. How do I ever, like, get his bishop out? I could do like that, but then he just, you know, goes somewhere here. Not easy to castle. Okay. Oh, wait. Okay, I'm just gonna go here. I'm gonna settle down. We're not gonna play King E2. Honestly, like King E2. How dumb is Queen G3? I thought about Queen G3. My first Stafford ornament, yeah. H4? I'm still entertaining the possibility of castling kingside, though, so maybe that's craziness, but... Okay, my idea was to play knight d1 and then knight f2. But he's sitting here threatening bishop g4. Don't want that. Hey, Helldesk! Giving out 5 subs. Thank you, Helldesk. And I got an emote somehow. Thanks for the 2020 takeout, Helldesk. Appreciate it, man. Very generous of you. And now I get to hear the Zelda thing for a while. I guess I gotta play h3, though I'm loath to do it. I don't really want this bishop coming here. That seems not good. Bishop there. Okay, so now knight d1. And knight f2 to follow. You know, I was thinking on knight d1, he couldn't take my b2 pawn because his bishop's hanging, but my rook's hanging. So that may not actually be a good idea. That's unfortunate. I was hoping it would be a good idea. Maybe I can revisit this g3 idea. I mean, it is a fork. But, I'm just worried I'm not really liberating my position very much. I would really like to liberate my position. But I don't know what else, I don't know what to do other than it, so I guess let's do it. Find out. And Helldesk gave the sub to Squirrel. Thank you, Helldesk. Yeah, you complained loudly enough, Squirrel. You want to play knight d5? Can he take that with a pawn? Oh yeah, g7's not hanging. I'm not gonna win this game. I'm playing too stupidly. Too dumb. Game stays complicated in Black's favor. Agreed. Bishop f4, no bother. I mean, it's probably a bother. Maybe not, though. Maybe I just say, okay, you can take my pawn, but I'm going to trade off the queens. Suddenly I'm down a pawn. But he's not interested in pawns. He's interested in killing me. And who can blame him? I just want to go here. Try to get rid of his bishop. Try. How's it going, the Suspenser? No Bond Cloud? I almost played King E2. Came pretty close. This better be lost for white. This might not be so bad. Getting some conflicting opinions in the chat. I mean, I would gladly, like, if I could offer my opponent, would you like to switch sides of the board? I would do it. Try flipping the board. Yeah, see if I can be... Exactly. What do I think of the Polish? I think it's, a garbage opening. I mean, it's obviously no Grob. Like, if you're gonna play it, play the Grub. What is Rook F1 supposed to do? I don't know. Improve my rook. Go here, try to kick out his bishop. Make me feel better. Yeah, I saw... Oh, he played King B8. He's a Ben Feingold fan, I guess. Alright, so here... My queen's pretty active, so got that going for me. Queen is reverse castle and kingside. Something like that, yeah. Yeah, he's always got bishop f4. But, and he can also take on b2 as long as my rook is chilling on a1. All my pieces are very active, yeah. I mean, the rook on f3 is probably my best piece, right? Nice open file. But I played h3, Dan. Isn't that all that you ever wanted? All right, let's try to just, you know, keep him from opening things up. If bishop f4, I guess I'm just playing rook takes f4, because everything else looks pretty bleak. Of course, that also looks bleak, but take that bishop yesterday. Well, this is the first time I've ever played against the Petrov, so I guess I'm going to have to learn how to play against the Stafford. Yeah, knight d1, I just thought queen b2 was too good. I thought about just playing rook b1 and then knight d1, which is slow, passive, and bad, but take the pawn and go back to f3. Yeah. Yeah, but then if I don't accept the gambits, you guys are like, come on, man, you gotta take the gambit. Like, that's not sound, and you gotta be brave. And what polls are we rigging today?
What polls are we rigging today?
Oh, knight d1 covers b2. Okay, yeah, I'm stupid. Yeah. Pretty stupid. I don't know. I guess the polls, you know, to figure out, you know, when I rage quit chess, what I'm gonna do next. Ugh. You rage quit chess last year? Nah, you gotta get back into it. Man, it's tough to do stuff. Guess I'll just keep sitting here waiting for him to win. Was the reason to keep the knight on c3 to prevent queen b2? Yeah, that was the reason, though it was faulty. But yeah, I, well, he's pretty good at playing passive and bad too, so gotta give him some props. It's not easy to play so badly all the time, but now I've got like some kind of gun. Scrabble Kitty, thank you for following. I mean, yeah, I gave up on the e5 pawn. Queen h1 triple exclaim, yeah. Hey, he finally took my pawn. Why did he do that? I don't know. I'll keep maneuvering my queen around in the circle. Rook b1? I mean, I guess I should bite the bullet and do that. But... a lot of tactics here, JK. Yeah, the bishop on e3 is pretty annoying. Maybe, but I mean, even after knight d1, it's not like I can castle. Hey, AMS Andrew, how's it going? Man, that's pretty... be interesting. Okay, I guess I'll go here. Loving the Sif music, literally just saw it at Sif6. I don't know who Christopher Tin is, but I'm guessing he's some sort of musician. H3 and A3, yeah.
H3 on the board.
I'm throwing for bits. Thank you, Dan. I agree with that assessment, Gigi Pizza. That's like most of the reason why I played A3. Composer of Baba Yetsu, say no more. Okay, I don't know what that move's about. Man, I can't even, like, find a legal move. This is like Zugzwang. Guess I'll go here, because don't know what else to do. Man, what a song. Baba Yetsu was the reason you started playing Civ 4. Yeah, it was a great song. It still is a great song. Might need that puzzle rush to pay off. Find some mate. Queen take. It's terrible, but. Oh, he's got some stuff hanging. Also, my bishop's pretty active. Oh, wait. Eh. I get a bishop. Okay. I have little say in the matter. Seems maybe things have turned. Always repeat. Yeah, I was hoping he would do that. Okay. I had kind of an oh shit moment after that. I was like, wait a minute, am I gonna make a threefold repetition there? Ah, he resigned. That's premature, but yeah, I mean, white's winning. Though it was three, it popped up and it said claim draw, and then I moved in like half a second so that he couldn't click it. Oh man, that was quite a swindle. So I've refuted the Stafford Gambit. None of you guys, don't worry about learning the Stafford. It's a trash opening. It's, you know, it's just totally winning for white. Yeah, if he was faster, he could have claimed a draw.